on Liverpool's Aintree course, the 103rd Grand National since Lottery won it first in 1839. Britain's greatest ever day of sport brought nearly 500,000 here for racing's most colourful classic. Driving rain reduced visibility to 100 yards. And now they're ready to go. 57 of the world's best bred horses are lined up. And they're off. Away over 4.5 miles of the toughest, roughest steeplechase. The biggest test that racing offers to horse and rider. Coming up to jump number one, we pick them up in normal motion as they come over. And now the slow motion camera comes in with superb action shots. Refugio is over first, followed by Lock Con and Prattler. One or two are straggling already, but the field is still packed tight. And now the first to fall, two horses. Revelry and EP are down. Here's jump number three. The Grey Domino and Little Lock Con from Ireland are in the lead. The jumps are bowling them over now, but the field is away and the big jumps are still to come. Number nine, Valentine's Brook. Lock Con still up in front. On his heels, another Irish horse, Kilnaglory, and still the Grey Domino. This is what takes it out. The inevitable riderless horses are there too. There's no future in it, but they keep on going. Anchor's Bridge and jump number 12. The leaders are still the same, plucky little Lock Con in front, but it's still anybody's race. All the bookies from England and Wales and one or two from Scotland are here to make up for the money they lost during the racing ban. And with 17-2 favourite Prince Regent still lying 10th, it looks as if this is yet another bookmaker's benefit. Leaders are still bunched together. Lock Con first and then Kilnaglory, Domino, Some Chicken, Prince Regent coming up in the rear. And so we go to jump 13 on the straight. Lock Con ahead, trailed by a bunch of loose horses. They're thinning out now. The jumps have taken their toll. And here they come into the bend for the second time round. There are still those riderless horses doing better without their jockeys. With a field like this, the bookies don't know whether they're paying out or cashing in. Here's where the race is won and lost. Valentine's Brook, second time round. Lock Con, number 24, is over first. He looks well set for Ireland. But now watch the winner come through. It's Kahoo. You can spot his white woolen noseband. Watch him come up from nowhere. It's Kahoo from now on. He's made his challenge, and at jump number 26, it's Lock Con and Kahoo up in the front, both from Ireland. Kahoo, 100-1. Now for the last falls. Only 26 horses left, and still more go down as they come to jump 27. Now it's Kahoo way up in front. Yes, Kahoo is well in the lead. An unknown Irish horse, his owner bought him for £50. Ridden by 35-year-old jockey Eddie Dempsey, he's well away. Owner Jack McDowell said he bought the horse for his mother. This must be quite a day for Mrs. McDowell. Kahoo's 20 lengths ahead. Only a fall can stop him now. Here are the last few furlongs, and it's Kahoo's race, an easy winner. Kahoo, 100-1 outsider, wins the 1947 National. It's an all-Irish triumph, with Lock Con second, French Bred, Carmi third, and Ireland's Prince Regent fourth. It's also a bookies' day. Their little black bags bulging with £1,000,000 from their 10,000-1 spring double. For winner Kahoo, a well-deserved pat on the back from jockey Dempsey. And it's the end of a grand, grand national.